Let's learn blood circulatory system.
This is our blood vessel.
Now, the blood is flowing in the blood vessel. Ooh, what is that? This is waste products such as urea and carbon dioxide. This is nutrients such as glucose, amino acids, and vitamins. This is white blood cell or leukocytes. It is to protect body against the bacteria and viruses.
Yeah!
This is red blood cell or erythrocytes. It is to transport oxygen.
Bloop 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 bloop.
This is platelets. It is for blood clotting. Now we are going to focus on blood clotting mechanism. This is our new friend, Ali. Hi, my name is Ali. The other day, Ali was walking, and suddenly he was hit by a car. Ouch! It hurts! Now, Ali has so many open wounds. Let us take a closer look. Oh no! The blood vessel is exposed to the outer environment. Platelets to the rescue! And now, the platelets is taken together to form a platelet plug. And then, thromboplastin or activators is formed. Oh, calcium ion and vitamin K is helping thromboplastin to change prothrombin to thrombin. And now, the presence of thrombin catalyzes the conversion of fibrinogen to fibrin. Lastly, fibrin form a mesh of fibers across the wound to trap red blood cell and seal the wound. The accident left a lot of scars. But what will happen if platelets do not play their roles in blood clotting process?
Condition when no platelets in blood clotting process. This is one. Oh no, there is no presence of platelets in the blood. How we want to cover the open wound? The blood is coming! The blood is coming! Oh no, there are few red blood cells come out from the wound. OMG, we are not safe. We will be attacked by the microorganism.
Now, the blood vessel is exposed to the bacteria and virus. If not, I experience prolonged bleeding.
No!
Or I will be infected and be like a zombie.
Zombie!